this wonderful set. Modesty probably prevents Peter from telling you who he is and his family, so I'm going to do a bit of an introduction there. His father, Ron, is a legend in Canadian automobiling out, and he has for years, since I was a kid in high school, I remember hearing about Ron Fawcett and his collection of cars. One of the things they did was they founded what's called the Fawcett Motor Car Company, which has a gigantic collection of every kind of vehicle imagined. And one of the things, if you ever see every old movie that you see on television, I believe it's true, they're all your cars, aren't they, Peter? Well, all of the cars that you see in all of the Canadian movies on TV, like Linda and Valkyrie, these are all your cars, aren't they?
There's a couple of them, but not all.
Anyway, that's one of the things he did. And this is his son, Peter, who's carrying on that tradition. And we couldn't have had a more spectacular example of the kind of car he's got than this. What year is this?
1905
Stanley Steamer. Everybody's heard of Stanley Steamers, but I never seen one. Too bad the technology didn't catch on. You know, today we're talking about alternate energy sources and everything. I love steam cars because they're quiet. But apparently nobody could ever have enough patience to wait for them to boil. It's like boiling a kettle, you know? And you get up in the morning and you turn on the burners and you have to sit around and wait forever for the thing to get hot. And people just wouldn't do that. So as far as I understand, that's the main reason that they never caught on. But what a wonderful automobile. And I don't know anything at all about this. Except, just let me mention before I pass the mic on, notice right away the evolution of the body size mounted entrance. The car is longer, see the wheelbase is longer. So all automobiles by this time are now stretching out and putting the words on the side. I'll pass it off to the other survivors.
Just before we have the fire.
All right.
Stanley Brothers, well, I'm sure most of the people on this area that deal with automobiles are aware of, started a steam automobile company that became Locomobile. And when they were able to sell that company, they originated another company called Stanley, and that was in 1903. And some of those very early Stanleys are still on the road as members with clubs that we have around the country. But Stanley's also recognized, like Henry Ford and others, that racing was the way to get people's attention. And they began to race at a place called Ormond Beach in Florida, which was this huge, flat, sandy area that lent itself to race cars. And they very quickly made a reputation for themselves at Ormond Beach. The particular car that you see here today is one of the rarest of Stanley Steamers that can be found. It is a Model F.